don't forget to subscribe. Here we are, we three queens. I'm Micheline.
I'm Aching.
And I'm Musonda.
Gosh, it's so nice to be back.
I know!
It is so nice to have you ladies. And we managed the whole a meter apart.
Yes.
Still, can you imagine we're still here in COVID-19 times? Somehow we're managing, perhaps thriving at times, you'll tell me, perhaps not.
Perhaps exhausted.
But it's been perhaps exhausted. Oh my goodness, working at home, homeschooling. And it's been, what, seven, eight months?
Yeah.
Time is becoming this weird kind of concept, I find.
Yeah.
Right? So to think that it's November, November feels like April. But that is essentially what I want to dig into today. How has it been, just in general? What's the good, the bad, the ugly?
Do you know what's funny for me? Talking about how you're saying, you know, November feels like April, you're not sure what time of the year it is, right?
What day of the week?
I'm telling you, it's all just a blur.
Yeah, if night didn't set, we wouldn't even realize nightfall has come.
It's crazy. You know, the people I meet that I have not seen since March,
yeah,
and I'm just like, I'm not sure how to greet you. Shall I say Happy New Year? Oh, Merry Christmas.
You're so funny.
Because I haven't seen you.
Yes, you're like, which... Yeah, and you know when you mention how to greet them, do you all struggle with that? Is it a... Tok, tok? Is it a...
Yeah.
Wakanda?
A dry hug? Is it a... Hi.
For my kids, I've had to actually really make sure that I teach them the Wakanda greeting.
Yes.
It's also just, you know, how do I encourage my children to be mindful of how they greet their friends or, you know, because children are children anyway, you know, they're going out there and they've been missing out and not going to school. So I was, you know, teaching them everywhere we go, who we're greeting Wakanda greeting. Yes, Mama, how do we greet Wakanda greeting?
In only with people I have to, I'll do the elbow, but generally I just say, hey, you know, from far. But then I've got the little COVID, sort of my COVID quarantine.
Yes.
Those guys we actually hug because we've spent COVID season together, and we've been very cautious. And you know, we've tested, had our COVID tests done, you know, at some point for whatever reason.
Yes.
So yeah.
Do you know when you were saying hugs, I was just like, oh, I had this just warm reaction because I realized in COVID-19 times that I love a hug.
Girl.
You know, I loved a hug.
Yeah,
and actually something happened quite recently. Yeah, it was like August. I guess we'd been in it.
Pause.
Who is it?
Oh. Hi.
Oh my God.
Hello.
You look amazing.
Was talking about both of you actually about greeting. I was thinking, I love a hug.
Yeah,
I know.
You know, and I really miss hugging. And of course, we do the whole Wakanda or the tok tok or whatever, hi from a distance. But just a few months, I think we had been maybe 6 months into COVID.
Mm-hmm.
So just, I don't know, September. I went to see a friend of mine, and I think she just forgot. Like, she had spent the whole day alone, hadn't seen her in maybe 2-3 weeks. And, you know, normally we know we had done the tok tok. She came and hugged me and we just held. And I had these two feelings, right? Overwhelmingly, I was like, I love a hug. I miss hugging. But 2% of me was like, okay, now if I get COVID-19, I guess, well, I hope that my immune system is really strong. I mean, I went through like all of this in 2 seconds.
Your brain is in overdrive.
And I was like, and I'll overcome it. And still, that hug would have been worth it. That hug.
I know.
Wasn't that precious?
September, October, and it's carrying me through November.
But do you know what? It's interesting when you say that 2% of the niggling at the back of your mind. You know what I did? I ended up stocking up on lemon and ginger and turmeric and everything. And anytime I felt... I'd go hot water, like I take like 2-3 cups.
Yes. You cannot afford to cough in public.
You can't. Have you guys seen the meme that was going around of somebody holding back a cough?
Can you imagine the stigma? Like,
you know when you have to hold back the cough because everybody wants to run?
It's terrible.
When I was in Frankfurt a couple of weeks ago, I had to do the test to take the flight back.
Yeah.
And you had to do it at the airport because that's the only place where you'd get one certified result
right.
That would enable you to board the flight. And there was a lady And every so there was a queue, long queue. We got there like at 7 in the morning. There was already a long, long queue. So we were there for like 2 hours.
Yeah.
But there was a lady who kept not social distancing. Gosh. Seriously. And then she started to cough a thick one. Oh. I kept thinking to myself, God, if she gives me COVID, so I don't know what I'm going to do. No, seriously, I was freaking out and I was giving her the look, because every time I moved, I'd give her a pointed look.
A proper like, daggers.
You know, kind of like, yeah, give me a minute here.
1 meter.
Like two, I wanted 2 meters. Because she was coughing a thick cough. Jesus. And poor thing, maybe it wasn't even COVID. But like we're paranoid.
That's actually
we
one
are,
way,
you know.
It's the paranoia
changed.
Yeah,
that
we're
is
nervous.
Not something that will. I don't think that's something that will go. I think even into next year, as we get a bit more comfortable, cross fingers that the vaccine shows to be efficacious, and we get it, you know, here.
We really
still
hope.
We'll be looking at people and. Gosh, that we've changed.
We have changed.
In, in many ways, actually.
Those ways, and I wonder. I mean, let's reflect a bit on that, actually, in terms of. How has COVID-19 changed us?
You know what? I didn't realize how much I love my own company. I love my own company.
Well, that's
and
nice.
I think having been in corporate where you're constantly running and you're constantly around people and you're constantly in meetings and presentations and stuff.
Yes.
I love just the me time that COVID has gifted me with.
Yes.
For me, it's been so amazing because one, I've been homeschooling, but also I've been finding time for myself. I'm thriving in working from home.
Yes.
But also part of my thriving is because I have decorated my home office nicely.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm also making time for me and also making time for the children. But also giving that permission for us to have the quiet time.
Yeah.
Like at lunchtime, I say, we have quiet hour now, guys. We're going to nap. Or you're going to read your book, or you're just going to sit in silence somewhere.
Yes.
And my children are respecting those boundaries. And in that quiet time, my phone's off, or it's on silent, or it's on do not disturb, and I'm not taking any calls. Unless it's really something that
discipline.
I had planned a while ago.
Yeah.
And it's been such a wonderful time
to
draw those boundaries.
Yeah.
And just tell us a tiny bit more about this home decor, your office decor.
Darling.
Like,
I have incense. I have wax incense of this fragrance called Norella, which I got for my friends.
I'll just come and be like I'm in the spa in your office.
You walk into there and it's just calming you down because you're in these intense webinars.
Yes.
Even though we're in a virtual world, it's like, you know, you're having conversations with, you know, 3, 4, 5 different cities around the world and different energies that are coming into your space.
Yes. You're so right, actually.
Yeah.
Decor really helps with that.
Yeah.
And, you know, as I think about that, one thing I'm doing is, there's a default, I guess, you know, of 1 hour slots for, you know, sort of for meetings, for calls.
Yeah.
And I actually really reflect on that. I have a 15 minute type of a call, a 30 minute and an hour.
Yes.
So whenever somebody's like, let's talk, and they slot in an hour, I actually sit and think through, these are the objectives. This is what we're, you know, talking about.
Is it worth an hour?
I just slice you down to half an hour. Thank you very much.
Absolutely.
You know, because like you said, it's somebody coming into your time, into your space.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And being on Zoom, being virtual has enabled us to manage that a bit more.
Yeah, and be more, I love that you're deliberate about
it.
Actually, that's something I do. Honestly. So Mondays, I never have meetings on Mondays.
Yeah.
And so if there's a meeting on a Monday, it's literally one of those 1 hour, let me dedicate a bit of the time that I was going to do all my stuff that may or may not have to do with work.
That's okay.
But Mondays, no meetings, and Friday afternoons, no meetings.
I love that.
And it's just a thing. And then I've also gifted myself with choosing what work I want to do. So
good
there will
you.
Be certain projects that come my way,
that's
and
right,
I will deliberately.
You have your own business.
Absolutely,
doing,
I'm self-employed. I do my, I do more consulting and stuff.
Yeah.
And I can choose, and I will deliberately. There are certain projects I won't do because I think to myself, that one I'll be running helter skelter. I'll feel so tortured. Honestly, let me not do it.
Good.
I'd rather do this other project. It may be smaller, but it'll be a lot more fun.
Yeah.
So I'm really
and
deliberate
aren't
about
we
that.
Working such long hours?
We
I mean,
are.
For me, I have said to everybody, I don't do emails, calls, or anything work related at the weekend.
But ladies, you know
that's
what?
Powerful.
As I listen to you both and actually reflect on similar, there's the other side of the world of work. And so many people have lost their jobs in COVID-19. So many people, I suppose, won't be able to relate, you know. So let's just have this gratitude, as I'm sure we have. Let's continue to be grateful.
Deep gratitude.
For work, for this flexibility that we're able to build, for this ability to choose what you will or will not do.
Yeah.
You know, I've been actually thinking a lot about that. Mm. And there's certain industries, you know, of course, the hairdressers, of course, aren't, you know, sort of doing well. Nobody wants to go and get
tough
up front.
We're doing our hair ourselves at home now.
You know, and my fundi, my tailor was in a pretty congested space. And so they had to sort of, you know, shut them down. So what I've thought about a lot is charity. Just thinking through what will $5, the equivalent of $5, you know, 500 shillings, or even 10, how is that going to hurt me since I have fewer expenses?
Yeah. Exactly. Like, we're not by sharing money that much.
Yeah, exactly.
So by sharing it, you know, I think it's going to be important to think in that direction, not only during COVID, but beyond, right? Because we are these very symbiotic communities, and I think we have to continue to have that spirit of basically that Ubuntu.
Absolutely.
For me, I feel like COVID made people even more generous.
Yes.
Because, you know, I'm sure you guys, and knowing you guys are generous of spirit anyway, you know, as your friend, I'm a huge beneficiary of your generosity in so many ways.
But the same here.
Guys,
I'm
so sincere when I say that, you know. But people are generous. You know, the minute it started, like in our court, you know, all the homes got together and, you know, we had a kitty and it was managed through the chairman and his wife. And she went off and, you know, we chipped into it, and she went off and shopped. And the workers
really
who work
good.
In our complex, they had a bag of, you know, cooking oil and grain and unga and
so, like
so on.
A
and
so basic
yes,
kit.
A basic nice. Kit every month for several months. I can't remember how long we did it for, 4 or 5 months.
Yeah,
we're not doing it anymore, but we're still supporting the different workers individually.
That's
for example,
great.
You know, my housekeeper worked for the first 3 months. She was on a full salary, but she was not coming to work actually for the first 3 months of COVID. But I told myself, she has a child. If I don't pay her, it's through no fault of her own that she can't come to work.
Exactly.
Yeah. I have to support her. And because I'm not going out anyway, you've got this, you know, you've got some saving.
Some.
You've got some you can share.
Exactly.
Share.
You know,
exactly.
So I mean, the same applies to me with you, like the house help. I mean, for 3 months, they didn't come. So I was doing everything with my kids and sort of also letting them, you know, make, you know, do their own little chores, etc., which they've always done.
Fantastic.
And I mean which they've always done anyway, and continue to pay them because, you know, it wasn't their fault. So I think a lot more people have become a lot more empathetic.
Absolutely.
Of circumstances.
I think so. Yeah.
Remember those, I don't know if you saw on online or, you know, on TV in Italy, really interesting acts of kindness in the early months of COVID. Mm-hmm. So people like out in their little terraces, because, you know, the small tiny apartments they have, and like singing.
Clanking pots.
Yeah. I mean, things like, you know, if you have a talent, how beautiful would that be, you know? Like, just because people were and still are in a bit of a funk and are quite isolated for those who live alone, you know?
Yeah.
So there are all these changes, but hey, so I was thinking about singing and wondering what's on your playlist, just in general, or what song is carrying you through COVID-19? Anyone? I'm okay, because I know we came in.
I've been listening.
I'm a piano, right?
Ooh, I'm a piano.
I discovered I'm a piano through
Please
you guys.
Discover I'm a piano. But what is, like, on your playlist? What are you loving?
So one of them that I've really been loving, because I obviously I have family in the US and I was following the elections, etc. I mean, is the Sam Cooke song "Change's Gonna Come."
Mm-hmm.
Ooh,
which one's that?
Fine by the river. Na 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 na. Change gonna come. Oh. Change is coming.
I love that.
And change has come for the world.
Yes.
Whether we like it or not.
It has.
Oh, that
it
is so
totally
motivating.
Has.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice one. How
so
about
for
you?
Me,
yes.
The one thing, so I Niger, my Niger.
Yo, wow.
I've lived off a Niger mix. Because I love to
Which
dance.
One? Like
actually, the one I really, really like that's got a whole mix of all of them, it's a Niger, it's called, I think if you go on SoundCloud, it's Niger Mix 2018, I think. By a guy called a DJ, DJ Hola.
Niger Mix 2018, DJ?
DJ Holup, H-O-L-U-P.
Hello.
Actually, his mixes are so good. I find myself dancing. If you saw me, you'd be thinking, has she lost her mind? Is she crazy?
I love it.
But it gets my energy up. It keeps me happy. Yes. My happy hormones are all just unleashed. Yes. And so I've done lots of dancing in my kitchen.
I love it. And
this
COVID season.
And dancing
is also like linked to working out
as well. I try.
Yeah. Oh my God.
And what about you?
You know what? I have two things. The one I want to talk about is, you know, like Latino bolero music, like big ballads. So there's one I was singing last night and it was something like,
drink some water.
Por amor, soy vivir. And then I was like, and I looked outside, and the guy, like the compound guy, was just kind of entertaining himself by looking at me. So I love it. So like your big, bold Latino, like songs in Spanish. You know?
Awesome.
So it's just, you know, gets me in a moment. And that one is, you know, for love we live. Oh, and yeah, why not?
For love indeed we live.
For love we live.
You know? Yeah. So, ladies, it's a wrap. So nice to have you. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you. It was awesome to reconnect with you guys in this COVID season.
So we will continue to try to keep chatting, you know, every month. Don't forget to subscribe and share with us your thoughts about these COVID-19 times. And please stay safe, stay masked and sanitized. And if you have to be together indoors, at least a meter apart. All right, people. Ciao, ciao.
Ta-da.